Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. Purchase requests are used to control the purchasing process with approvals in place to keep track of what is being purchased by who, to make sure that cost-effective decisions are being made on the project to keep everything within the project budget. So in this video, we're going to look at how you can standardize, streamline, and track your purchase requests with a Dashpivot workflow, which is what you see here, to ensure that your approval process is followed every time. So we've already got our purchase request template set up inside of Dashpivot, and it's been set up as a workflow. You can see that we've got three columns here. And the idea is that if we add a request, it's first going to appear in this first column, and then once it's signed off by the requester, it'll move to the second column for financial approval before moving across to our closed column. So let's run through an example. If I click on Add Request, our template has already been set up. So we've got our form here, which needs to be filled out. We've got some fields up the top, brief description of the request. Let's say it's just some concrete, maybe it's 20 meters cube of concrete. Date required, maybe it's due sometime this week. We're working in area 3, let's say. We can just work our way down the form. This one's split into two sections. So we've got section one for the requester. So we've got all the detail about what the request is. This one's got a nice table, so we can set up some preloaded dropdowns for different suppliers. We could add in as many line items and the quantities for each. We've got a dropdown for cost codes and the price and comments and things like that. So we can add in as much detail as we need here. And then the second section of this form is for the approver. So we've got some questions about, you know, was this the most cost-effective way of making this purchase? Section for comments, and then, of course, the outcome. And you'll notice that for each of these sections, there's a signature at the bottom. So we've got section one, there's a signature for the requester. Section two, there's a signature for the approver. And because in Dashpivot, this template has been set up as a workflow, we need to have these special signatures, which we call approval signatures, which indicate to us that when they're signed, it'll actually move this form to the next column. And so these signatures actually have to be signed off in sequence. So the first one is currently enabled, but the second one isn't. And that's because these have to be, of course, signed off in the correct order. So if we were to sign this form without if we were to save this form without signing it, it'll appear in the first column of our workflow. But then what we can do is we can open that up and we can sign. What that will do is it will stamp our signature with the time and date on here. And then as we save it, it will actually move our form now from the first column to the second column. And this is the way that the workflow works. So then we could open that up again, and let's say that we're the approver this time. We can come in and fill out this section and sign with our signature, and the signature actually locks everything above it as well, which you might have noticed. It's locked off our category field here, the text field, this checkbox, all of this information, it's all locked off, and that's because it's been signed. If we save it now, because both signatures are on there, it's now moved across to the closed column. So that's the essence of the workflow inside of Dashpivot. One of the neat things about it is that we can set up some notifications if we want. So in the case of a purchase request, maybe our financial controller or the project manager within this team needs to essentially sign off each request coming through. They might want to receive an automatic notification each time a form moves into this column. We can do that with Dashpivot. So we can set up, by clicking this eyeball here, we can select from all the people who have access to this team who we'd like to notify. And for example, if I was to select Hudson, maybe Hudson is our financial controller in this case. What this means is if I was to add a new request, it would appear here, and then once it's signed off, it'll move to the second column. And by moving to the second column, it will actually send Hudson an email. And it will say, Hudson, there's a purchase request sitting in the second column of this workflow. Click here to view it. Hudson could then come into Dashpivot, open it up, review that information, sign it off, and then move it to the third column. So that's effectively how the workflow works. Over time, you might end up with hundreds of records stored in here. And it might look something like this, where you've got records now sitting in every column. It's easy to tell what is about to be requested, what has been requested but hasn't been approved, and then, of course, what has been approved. That's the beauty of the workflow. But we may want to view this information slightly differently. We can click on the register view, and what that will do is it will create a row for every form which has been filled out and a column for each of the fields on our form. So you might remember that if we open up a form, we've got a section for the request, the date required, and the area. We've got those here. So we've got the date required, the request, and the area. And we can rearrange these columns if we'd like. We can click this Edit Columns button, and we can turn certain columns on and off. We can also rearrange them however we'd like, and that will customize this register view. You'll be able to organize the information the way that you want. And then the other beauty of the register view is that we can apply some filters. So we can say, all right, well, show me all of the forms or the purchase requests that were related to zone one, let's say. So we can, under the area column, because it's a category field, we can apply a filter and say, show me all of the forms from zone one. And it will refine our results to just the purchase request from zone one. And from here, if we needed to export this out for whatever reason, it's really easy to do. We can make a selection, or we can bulk select everything, and then our export options appear at the top. So we can export it to a CSV file if we needed to open this up into Excel. We could export the register as a PDF, or we can download each of these individual forms as a PDF as well. And the last thing that I want to show you in this video is that if we were to open up one of these forms, if we needed to send this purchase request to someone as a PDF copy, maybe after it's been approved, we can open this up and we've got a send as PDF option up the top. So we can click on that, we can type in someone's email address, click send, and that person will receive a PDF version of this form which has been filled out with, you know, your company branding up the top and details about what project it is and a couple other things there. So it'll package everything nicely. If you want to get started using this purchase request template, if you go to the template section of your team or your template library and click on Add New Template, we do have a purchase request template available for free inside our public template library. So if you click on Choose from Free Public Template Library, you can search for purchase request and it will load up the example which we've run through today into your team. And you can get started using that. You can always go in and modify that later down the track as well. It's very easy to do. If you get stuck on anything, we do have a live chat on the website. So you can open this up here, and we've got two options. You can either search for an article, and we do have some articles on purchase requests and the best practices there. And you can search pretty much our entire FAQ and knowledge base through here. But you can also ask us a question. So you can click on New Conversation, say hello, and it'll come through to someone from our team, and we'll do our best to get back to you as soon as we can. So that's really how you can streamline, control, and track your purchase requests and purchase orders with Dashpivot. I hope that this video has been useful, and thanks for watching.